Welcome to The Journey. Today we'll be talking about best practices for creating email signatures. You know, it's surprising that a lot of small businesses don't really take advantage of using their email signatures in their daily communications with their customers.
Yeah, when it comes to business emails, a signature is the most important tool that you can use for branding or just communication or marketing.
Definitely agree, Alex. Your email signature is a great opportunity to, you know, showcase different things that you want to get over to your client, like your contact information, your name, your title, your business's name, along with your branding. You can include your logo, or even now in advanced technology, you can include a photo of yourself.
For me, the biggest benefit is just to save time as well. You don't have to, you know, write that at the end of every single email. It does it for you. But also think about the benefits from, you know, all of a sudden now your customers know that you're with the times, you're up to date with technology, it makes you look professional.
All right, so here at GoDaddy, we use Office 365. So we're gonna just take you through a few steps on how you can log in if you use that application. And just know for whatever email client you're using, it could be a little different. All right, so for the first step, you wanna go to the little cog here that we have on the screen, that's your settings. Scroll down to view all Outlook settings. So on this next page, thankfully for us, mail is already highlighted on the left. Then you want to go to compose and reply. And as you can see, my email signature is already set up here. You can put in those elements that you want, your name, your title, logo, website. So here you can actually click a few things. If you want to automatically include your email signature in every new message, you can click this box here. Or also, if you want to make sure that your email signature is included in every message that you reply to, you'll click this box here. And then once you are finished, you want to make sure that you hit save. And you're done.
So now you know where to go to actually do this, but what goes into creating an email signature? Here are the best practices when creating one for your business.
So for our first tip, you want to keep your email signature to no more than 6 lines. You want to be very concise. You don't want to have too much information there to where people get overwhelmed. You don't want to spam them with overly promoting things for your business. Very simple. Just have the basics there that, you know, people need. For example, your name, your business name, your number. Things for people to get in contact with you. Maybe even your website. You can include that as well.
And something to keep in mind, you don't have to include your email address. Mm-hmm. Typically, that's kind of standard to include that, but it doesn't really make sense if you think about it. Your email address is already going to be included at the top. Mm-hmm. It's pointless, it's wasted space, and you could use that line to include something else. Our next tip is stay away from sounding too salesy. This is your contact information. Yes, you can include, you know, a call to action, but at the same time, you don't want to sound too overzealous and you want to look credible. So don't use a bunch of different fonts and exclamation points and colors. So for example, let's look at the email signature that I use. Mm-hmm. Sam, I sent you this email. And so I'll walk you through really what goes into mine. So I have my name, I have my title, and the company I work for, the phone number to get in contact with me. And then I also included my LinkedIn profile because for me, that's a great way for people to verify that I actually am who I am and that I do work for GoDaddy and I'm not just some robot trying to spam them. So, and then of course the GoDaddy logo so that they can be familiar with that brand as well.
So for our next tip, use proper punctuation and grammar. You want to make sure that when you're sending this email signature out, it's putting your best foot forward. So for instance, for you, Alex, I see that you have all of the necessary punctuation and proper grammar. So we have your name capitalized where it needs to be. Then you also have, even for LinkedIn, the L is capitalized. There's no funny grammar issues there. And this is a perfect way of presenting yourself in a professional way.
The next thing to remember is if you are including a link to your website or social media profile, anything like that, you want to make sure that that link has that HTTPS in it. Because if the link doesn't work, then it's pointless. They're not going to copy and paste it. So make sure that that link is actually going to work.
And if you're a little tech savvy, another thing that you could do, say, take some of these images. For instance, we could have in Alex's signature the logo for GoDaddy. We could hyperlink the image to take people to the website for GoDaddy.
Ooh, I need to do that.
Yeah, it's pretty cool.
And I mentioned earlier that email signatures are a really great way to help save time Well, another way that you can do that as well is to also include that sign off in your signature. So if you always say thank you or all the best, regards, you can actually include that, and that's one less thing that you have to worry about.
And I like to say, have a great day on purpose. Something I came across a couple years ago. Yeah, so another thing with saving time, next tip is create different templates with your email signatures. For me, if I'm sending an email to a client, there's certain closings that I may say to them than I would say to actually a coworker. For instance, I have this email pulled up here, and it's just like an overview of their service. And as I close, I'll say, hey, have a great day on purpose. And then I have my email. But then if I'm sending an email to a coworker, I may say, happy hump day. You know, just create a nice little salutation. But the email signature, the closing, I'll say, thank you for your assistance or best regards. You can just change it up. And you have different ways of utilizing that email signature. Now for you, you can actually have maybe your website in your email signature, sending it to a certain client. Or you can say, join my email list to a different client. The options are endless.
You can also switch up the formality of your name as well. So if your name is Elizabeth, but all of your coworkers know you as Lizzie, well then you have, you know, the email signature for your coworkers, but then maybe a more formal one for your clients or customers.
Some of my coworkers know me as Scootaboot.
Literally no one calls you that, Sam. But the bottom line here is an email signature is all about leaving a great lasting impression. It's your last bit at the email. Make sure that you're giving off a great impression that showcases that you're professional, credible, and it's easy for your customers or clients to get your information.
Well, you just learned best practices for creating your email signatures. Be sure to like and comment on this video.
And don't forget to subscribe to our channel and ring that bell so that you're the first to know whenever we upload more new videos. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.
Scooby-Doo.